Hello, today I'll be walking through how to use our Python SDK. The SDK is designed to help you interface with Domo from Python easily. And so we will walk through some of the basic options here, and we will refer you to our GitHub page for additional details. The first thing that we need to do after importing a few libraries is to create an object that will hold the credentials for Domo. So here on line 6, you can see that we're creating a variable called Domo, and we're calling the Domo function, and we're sending in the credentials that we have allocated to ourselves using the developer.domo.com website. The next thing that we will do is we will download a data set from Domo. So you can see here we're using the dsget function, and we're sending in a dataset ID. Once this is finished, we have a data frame called car data that has this data set from Domo in it. The next thing that we want to do after that is to create a new data set in Domo. So what I'm going to do on line 2 is perform a simple aggregation. And then here again on line 6, I'm going to call the dscreate function. I'm going to give it the data frame with the summary in it, and then send it the name and the description of the data set. Note that the description is optional. When this is finished, you can see that Domo is going to return the new dataset ID of the dataset that we just created. We can use this in the future in order to update that dataset as many times as we like. Also, just to double check, we can go into Domo and notice that this new dataset exists here. We can click into the dataset and see that it exists just like any other dataset in Domo would. All right, the next thing that we want to do is make an update to that dataset. On line 3, you can see that I'm performing an additional aggregation. And then here on line 4, I'm going to use the dsupdate function, again sending it the dataset ID of the newly created dataset and this new data frame that we've created. Note that we have a warning here that the schema has been updated. In this case, we expected that, and so everything's okay. If we go into Domo, you can now see that we have 2 additional columns on this data set. With that, we've shown you how to get data from Domo, create a new data set, and also update a data set. The next thing that we will look at is how to create PDP policies. In order to create PDP policies, we use a couple of additional objects from the SDK. You can see here on lines 5 through 8, we're creating a policy filter object, specifying what column we want to search, and then specifying the values here that we're going to grant access to. In this case, it's just the value Honda. Next, we'll create a policy object, and then we will give the policy a name. We'll specify any of the filters that we've set up, the type, and then lastly, the users and the groups that we want to grant access to. In this case, you can see that we're not granting direct access to any users, but we are granting access to this one group. Finally, we'll call the PDP create function. We'll give it the dataset ID of the dataset where we want the policy to exist, and then we're going to give it this request. This happens relatively quickly, and then you can see down here that the SDK has returned the actual policy. We know it was successful because we've been allocated an ID. Additionally, you can go over into Domo and note that this new policy exists on the dataset. So the next thing that we'll do is look at how to interact with groups using the Python SDK. This first function, you'll notice the groups list function will return a list of all of the groups in Domo. You can also use the users list function to return a list of all users, just for reference. This next function, the groups list users function, will list all of the users that are currently in a specific group. In this case, you'll notice that we are looking at the US South Division group. So lastly, we can use the groups add users function in order to add users to this group. So you can see that, again, we've specified the ID of the US South Division, and then we've given it a user ID of the user that we want to add. Lastly, we will list the users once again just to confirm that they've all been added to the group as we requested. So here, after running it, again, we've got the user that already existed in that group, plus the user that we just added. With that, we have covered a quick summary of how to use the Python SDK. We will refer you back to Domo and also to our GitHub page for more details. Thank you.